is, you know, when Aaron was being really mean to Melanie, and everybody was saying, you know, to Aaron that he was trying to control her and all this, and it looked like he was being abusive, that clip. I think that they should go to counseling and open up with that clip. Hello, everybody. It's Moonlight Mason. Thank you for being here. This video is going to be my opinion, allegedly, all my opinion, so don't come after me. But if you enjoy this video, do give it a thumbs up. It helps the girl out. And leave a comment if you like. Let's get into it. The last time we spoke, they weren't engaged. Now Melanie and Aaron are engaged to be married. The ring is absolutely beautiful. I am so happy for her. It is a beautiful ring, and my fingers are crossed that she gets to keep it if something was to happen. Now, I'm not making this video to try to curse the relationship or, you know, send any shade. It's just that I'm an honest person, and I like to see things clearly, and I'd like to, you know, help you guys see a different perspective. Now, I see Aaron two different ways. I see him as a nice Aaron, and then he has a mean side. But who cares, right? I mean, the dude is fine. And you know what? When I was in my 30s, when I was in my, you know, 20s, if I saw a guy like Aaron, and he's got all that money and everything, wrong, girl. He could be living on the second bush from the right of 2nd Street. A lot of women would want to be with Aaron just because of his looks. Now, on the flip side, we got this dangerous guy going on. He's like real protectant. He's got a nice body. So he's attractive. Been in a relationship like that before? It's like a light switch, and you don't know how they're gonna be the next time you see them, depending on if they're angry or what their mood is, you know? And especially if you're around someone who does drugs or, you know, drinks alcohol, then, you know, it's not worth it. It's not worth it to go through that. If you're in a relationship with someone that can turn on you, like, you know, like go from being really nice and sweet and respectful to just being completely vile towards you and really put you down in public. It's just something, you know. And if that person who does that recognizes it and says, you know, I need to work on something too, because he did mention, oh God, he mentioned it. He mentioned this behavior that we're talking about when he had stated to Melanie, I'm not in love with you for your shortcomings, but then he goes, but I am, you know, blah blah blah. And the thing about it is like, he goes, and for me, and right away he put, like, not only did he put the but in there because he caught himself, you see, because you're supposed to be in love with someone for their bad and their good, for their, when they're rich, when they're poor, when they're healthy, when they're sick. All those things, right? But Aaron said to her, I'm not in love with you for your shortcomings. But I am. And then he kind of, like, you know, switched that sentence around a little bit. And then he said right away, and for me, like, you know, let me take some more responsibility to try to get him out of what he just said. And he goes, I'm not going to fly off the handle when she tells me something I'm not going to like, you see? So if you listen carefully, I'm hearing Melanie say to Aaron, you know, I'm gonna, is that okay? And he goes, okay. So OnlyFans. Apparently, Melanie can't have an OnlyFans by herself. So, you know, they're gonna do it together because obviously Aaron makes the money. That this is what Aaron said. They were both there when this went down. They just don't see the implications, the long-term implications of only Aaron making money, as he stated. Watch out, Melanie. The stream of Aaron playing the piano and how that was deleted. Oh my God, you guys, if you missed it, it was amazing. It really was everything that Melanie is saying that it was. It was great. Beautiful. The thing is he played like different, you know, music on there and with no notes or anything. And he said, I heard him say that he could listen to something like once or twice and then just be able to play it like on the piano. So he's very, very talented. Just say we start hearing any, which we already have. I'm telling you, we already have heard comments from Aaron towards Melanie in public that are very, very negative, very derogatory. But this is for the future. Okay, let's just go forward, you know. Let's see if we hear any more negative than positive comments, you know. And let's see if there's any resentment with the finances when, you know, Aaron's talking about, you know, who makes the money. I make the money, Aaron says. Well, let's see if there's going to be any. The key is to avoid resentment, and that is by always honoring your truth and having enough self-love and self-worth to recognize the beginning signs of a toxic relationship. Now, if all of a sudden, Melanie, and any of you who are listening to me, your partner is not holding you like a priority, all of a sudden you've taken, you know, a lower notch than the priority, there's a warning sign there, and there's something that calls for some sort of conversation where you can express how you're feeling and the other person can, you know, you guys can talk about it, which is key, and that is talking to each other. Also, when you go to counseling, like they said, they're going to counseling. I think that's wonderful. But go in, like I started the video, go in and show them that clip, because that clip of Aaron berating Melanie publicly on social media and putting her down, that clip alone will ruin this relationship. Now, this is my opinion only, okay? But maybe I'm seeing it, all right? Melanie probably knows more and his girlfriends know more. Maybe the mean side of Aaron comes up when he has a beer, when he has, you know, I don't know, you know, something else, if he does anything else, allegedly. But we've got to figure out what those triggers are. Aaron needs to figure that out. And that's where the counseling should come in, because that does not show a respect and a genuine love that will last forever. All right, you guys, this is my video. I hope you enjoyed it. And let me know in the comments below if you like it. And do subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye. It's kind of a passive-aggressive mood.